Good morning, my dear students. Welcome to chemistry online class. So we have started with the chapter number 1. So that is a introduction to chemistry. Myself Ramesh RG, chemistry teacher. So previous class we learnt about some basic important definitions, like definition of science, definition of chemistry, definition of inorganic chemistry, and definition of organic chemistry, right? So what is the meaning of, so what is the definition for science? Science is a deals with the study of knowledge by truth and facts, by observation or experiment for the living and non-living things. So this is the simple definition for science. Clear? So science is broadly divided into three categories or branches. One is a physics, chemistry and biology, right? So physics, so what is the meaning of physics? Physics is a branch of science which deals with the different form of energy, example light, sound, electrical, heat, etc. So these are the definition for physics. So next move on to the chemistry. So what is a definition for chemistry? So chemistry is also a branch of science which deals with the study of substances or chemicals or chemical reactions, example composition, preparation and their reactions. Clear? So chemistry is broadly divided into two main branches. So one is a inorganic chemistry, second one is the organic chemistry. So what is the definition for inorganic chemistry? So inorganic chemistry is a branch of chemistry which deals with the study of the elements and compounds or metals or non-metals. So this is the definition for inorganic chemistry. Next move on to the definition for organic chemistry. So organic chemistry is a branch of chemistry which deals with the study of specific carbon compounds only, example carbons and hydrogens. So these are the previous two class we learned. Clear? So in this class let's talk about the some apparatus. So whatever the glass apparatus we are used in a chemistry laboratory. Clear? So the glass apparatus are consisting of test tubes, beaker, flasks and retort. So first picture indicates the test tube, second picture indicates the beaker, third, fourth and fifth are indicates the flasks. Is it clear? So first we are looking at the test tubes. So what are the test tubes? So what are the uses? So how to use the test tube in a laboratory, right? So first is the test tube. So first tube, it is a special glass with a one open end. So look at the above. So one end is a open and one end is a close below. So we call it as a test tube. So these test tube are varying their sizes. It may be 1 ml, 2 ml, 5 ml or 10 ml. So based on their size, so we can make it made as a test tube based upon the, their performance. Clear? Second one is, so it is a hard glass test tube made up of Phyrex. It is called as a boiling tube. So we can also called as, test tube is also called as boiling tube. Is it clear? So next, so how to, so what is the uses of this test tube in our chemistry laboratory? Is it clear? So one is a, so we can use a test tube for chemical reaction or studying of the reactions. So this is the first use for test tube. Second one, for use as a special purpose in a laboratory. So first use, we can use for heating the chemicals and studying the chemical reactions. Second one is, it is a this test tube used to special purpose for laboratory. Is it clear? This is about the test tube. So you know the structure of test tube. So at the upper end it should be open, lower end it should be closed. It is a narrow tube. Is it clear? Next move on to the second, it is a beaker. So it is a glass container with a lip available in various size. So look at the above, there is a lip structure is present in the above. Is it clear? So Beaker is a widely calibrated or graduated lipped glass or plastic apparatus used for transferring liquid solution which do not normally require very accurate measurements. Clear? So this is about a beaker. So what is the uses of this beaker? So beaker is used for holding or pouring or mixing the solutions or mixtures. So we use for this beaker in laboratory. So first use for beaker, it is used for holding and pouring and mixing the chemicals or solutions or mixtures. We are use this beaker. So these beakers are also a variation there in size. So look at the first picture. So that is a 550 ml, 100 ml, 250 ml, 1 liter. So based upon their size, the beakers are available. Clear? You are clear the concept now. First is a test tube. Second one is the beaker. So first is test tube. So what is about test tube and their uses? Second one is the beaker, about the beaker and their uses. So next move on to the conical flasks. Clear? So glass appears. Conical flasks are variation in size. The conical flasks are divided into conical flask, round bottom flask and flat bottom flasks. Clear? So now look at the conical flask. So what is the use of a conical flask and so what is the characteristics of the conical flask? A conical flask is a moderately narrow glass apparatus with a wide base. Look at the base size. It is a wide base and no graduated. It means we can use this conical flask for storage of various chemicals and for mixing the different solutions together. We are using these chemicals. So this conical flask, is it clear? So this is about the flask. Look at the structure. So how it looks? So at the base, it is a narrow glass apparatus. Clear? And it is used for mixing of different chemicals or different mixtures. This is about the conical flask. So next move on to the round bottom flask. So observe the picture of the round bottom flask. Is it clear? So round bottom flask is a moderately narrow glass apparatus with a wide round base. So previously it is a narrow base. Now it is a round base. Clear? So how? So where we use this round bottom flask? It means, so for gas preparation, where heat is required. So where we heat some chemicals by using this round bottom flask. So it is used for gas preparation where heating is required. Because when we heat the chemicals, it is a uniformly distributed throughout and heating. Clear? So whatever there in the solution, we can eat throughout the reaction. So that's why round bottom flask we are using for gas preparation where it is required. Is it clear? So next is move on to the flat bottom flask. So first test tube, then beakers. Now it is about the flasks. In that conical flask, round bottom flask, now it is a flat bottom flask. So look at the pictures and observe the pictures. So at the base, it is a narrow glass apparatus with a wide round base with a small flat bottom. Look at the down of the diagram apparatus. It is a small flat bottom, right? Compared to the round bottom flask. So for flat bottom flask is a small flat bottom. Clear? So it is also a variation in their size. So flat bottom flask is a moderately narrow glass apparatus with a round base with a small flat bottom. So this is about a flat bottom flask. So where we can use this flat bottom flask? So we can use this flat bottom flask for gas preparation where gas is not required. Is it clear? It is also used for the gas preparation, but where heating is not required, for that we are using this flat bottom flask. Is it clear? Because when we take this is for heating, for gas preparation, when we heat this glass apparatus, uniform distribution of is not necessary. So sometimes we have preparation of gas, we don't want to any heat, right? So that time we are using this flat bottom flask. So when we heat required, we are using a round bottom flask. Is it clear? So this is about the today's class. So in this class we learned about the glass apparatus used in the chemistry laboratory. The glass apparatus consisting of test tubes, beakers and retort. Is it clear? So retort we have continued the next class. So in this class we learned only about the test tubes, beakers, flasks. In that, conical flask, round bottom flask and flat bottom flask. So one characteristic and one uses is enough. Clear? Any doubt regarding this or glass apparatus, you can contact my number. Clear? I provide below this video. Thank you, students. Have a nice day.